sorghum cultivation practices. Overview: taxonomic classification, crop botany, economic importance, distribution, sorghum injury and poisoning, soil and climatic requirements, varieties and hybrids, seed rate and seed treatment, sowing and spacing, growth stages, nutrient management, irrigation management, weed management, cropping system, insect management, yield attributes, harvesting, yield and storage, post-harvest technology. Taxonomical classification: kingdom Plantae, that is plants. Division Magnoliophyta, flowering plants. Class Liliopsida, monocotyledons. Order Cyperales. Family Poaceae, grass family. Genus Sorghum, species Bicolor. Vernacular name Jonalu. Crop botany: root, fibrous root system. Stem, erect, 50 to 180 cm in height. Internodes are short at the base and longer above. Color of the stem may be green or purple wash. Leaves, simple, alternate, glabrous, long. Below the leaf surface, waxy coating will be there, which prevents evaporation of water. Boot leaf will not completely open until the panicle comes out. Spikelet, sessile or pedicellate. Crop botany: Andrecium, stamens 3, Anthus dorsiflexus. Gynoecium, style 2 with plumostigma, protogynostigma, receptive to 5 to 8 days. Pollination, self and often cross-pollination. Fruit, Caryopsis. Seed, Endospermus. Economic importance of sorghum: sorghum is the fifth most important cereal crop in the world after wheat, maize, rice and barley. Sorghum is cultivated for grain and as a major food crop in much of South Asia, Africa and Central USA. In the US, Australia and South America, sorghum is grown mainly for animal feed. In addition to these uses of the grain, sorghum crop residues and green plants also provide sources of animal feed, building material and fuel for cooking, particularly dry land areas. Consumption of sorghum for food purposes is declining because of a change in food habits and consumer preference brought about by economic status, whereas use for animal feed and other industrial purposes is increasing. Sorghum is used for food, fodder and the production of alcoholic beverages. It is the fifth most important cereal crop grown in the world. Grain composition: protein 10.4%, carbohydrates 72.2%, fat 1.9%, fiber 12.6 grams, ash 1.6 grams, calorie 25 milligrams. Distribution: classification. Harlan and DeWitt gave a modified and simple classification based on spikelet type. A. Basic races: Bicolor, Gunia, Caudatum, Kaffir, Durra. Now cultivated sorghum is sorghum bicolor. Hybrid races: Gunia bicolor, Caudatum bicolor, etc. Area production and productivity. Area 4.02 million hectares. Production 3.75 million tons. Productivity 960 kilograms per hectare. Sorghum poisoning: young plants, that is 30 to 40 days stage, contain cyanogenic glucoside durin. Durin in the stomach of animals is converted into hydrocyanic acid. Thus, when young plants about 5 kg of sorghum are fed to animals, it causes carcinogenic death of cow. This is known as prussic acid poisoning or sorghum poisoning. Hessian content is more in leaves. Concentration of Hessian is more in morning and in summer. The toxic limit of Hessian is 200 ppm and concentration decreases after 50 days. To overcome this problem, avoid feeding sorghum before 50 days stage. Hay and silage are generally free of Hessian. Sorghum injury: sorghum stubbles or roots have high CN ratio, 50:1, that is, it contains low amount of nitrogen. Hence, microbes take the soil nitrogen for decomposition than from the decomposed stubble, which causes temporary immobilization of soil nitrogen. Hence, succeeding crop after sorghum is affected due to nitrogen in the early stage called sorghum injury. Sorghum soil requirements: sorghum will yield best on deep, fertile, well-drained loamy soils. However, it is quite tolerant of shallow soil and rocky conditions. Soils with clay loam or loam texture, having good water retention capacity, are best suited for sorghum cultivation. Sorghum is sensitive to aluminium toxicity, and soils with acid saturation higher than 20% can pose a problem. It does well in pH range of 6.0 to 8.5 as it tolerates considerable salinity and alkalinity. Sorghum climatic requirements. It is also widely grown in temperate regions and at altitudes of up to 2300 meters in the tropics. It can tolerate high temperature throughout its life cycle better than any other crop. Sorghum requires about 26 to 30 degrees centigrade temperature for good growth. The minimum temperature for the germination of the sorghum seed is 7 to 10 degrees centigrade. It is generally grown between 40 degrees north and 40 degrees south of the equator in warm and hot countries, characteristic of the semi-arid environment. It is one of the toughest drought-tolerant crops available, hence called as camel crop. It is a short-day C4 plant. Summer plowing. Summer plowing is advantageous to kill the weed seeds and hibernating insects and disease organisms by exposing them to the heat of summer. Initial plowing should be carried out at optimum moisture range to get good tilth and should avoid when moisture is in excess. Varieties and hybrids. Andhra Pradesh CSH25, CSH23. Varieties CSV23, CSV20. Field preparation. Rain-fed sorghum. Field has to be prepared well in advance, taking advantage of early showers. Farmyard manure application should be done at the rate 12.5 tons per hectare and well incorporated at the time of plowing. Chiseling for soils with hard pan. Chisel the soils having hard pan formation at shallow depths with chisel plow at 0.5 meter interval, first in one direction and then in the direction perpendicular to the previous one once in 3 years. Apply 12.5 tons farmyard manure or composted coir pit per hectare besides chiseling to get an additional yield of about 30% over control. To conserve the soil moisture, sow the seeds in flatbeds and form furrows between crop rows during intercultivation or during third week after sowing. Field preparation. Irrigated sorghum. Nursery preparation. For raising seedlings to plant 1 hectare, select 7.5 cents, 300 meters square, near a water source where water will not stagnate. Laying the nursery. Provide 3 separate units of size 2 meter by 1.5 meters with 30 centimeter space in between the plots and all around the unit for irrigation. Excavate the soil from the inner surface and all around to a depth of 15 centimeter. Form channels and spread the soil removal on the bed and level. Main field preparation for irrigated crop. Plowing. Plow the field with an iron plow once or twice. Sorghum does not require fine tilth since it adversely affects germination and yield in case of direct sown crop. To overcome the subsoil hard pan in alfi soils, in deep red soils, chiseling the field at 0.5 meter interval to the depth of 40 centimeter on both the directions of the field, followed by disc plowing once and cultivator plowing twice, help to increase the yield of sorghum and the succeeding black gram also. This was true with sorghum followed by groundnut also. Application of farmyard manure and 100% of recommended nitrogen can also be followed. In soils with subsoil hard pan, chiseling should be done every year at the start of the cropping sequence to create a favorable physical environment. Formation of ridges and furrows. Form ridges and furrows using a ridger at 6 meter long and 45 cm apart. Form irrigation channels across the furrows. Alternatively, form beds of size 10 meter square and 20 meter square depending on the availability of water. Sowing. Field preparation depends on the systems of sorghum sowing. 3 systems of sorghum sowing are sowing on a flat surface using ridge and furrow system or on a broad bed and furrow system. If sowing is done on a flat surface, the land should be leveled after final plowing using bullet drawn or tractor drawn wheel levelers. Sow the seeds over the line where the fertilizers are placed and cover with soil. Sowing time. 3rd week of June to 1st week of July with onset of monsoon. ridge furrow sowing system. Seed rate or seed treatment. Seed rate, rain fed, 15 kg per hectare and irrigated, 7.5 to 10 kg per hectare. Treat the seed with 14 ml imidacloprid, gaucho, plus 2 grams carbendazim, davistin, per 1 kg seed or thymethoxam, crucem, 3 grams per kg seed. Fertilizer requirements. For light soil and low rainfall areas, 60 kg nitrogen, 30 kg P2O5 and 20 kg K2O per hectare. Apply 30 kg nitrogen and total phosphorus and potash at sowing and remaining 30 kg nitrogen at 30 to 35 days after sowing. For medium or deep soils and moderate to high rainfall areas, 8 kg nitrogen, 40 kg P2O5 and 40 kg K2O per hectare. Apply half nitrogen plus full P2O5 and K2O and remaining nitrogen at 30 days. Spacing. Row to row, 45 cm. Plant to plant, 12 to 15 cm. Maintain plant population as 180,000 plants per hectare. That is 72,000 plants per acre. Sorghum thinning. Thinning should be completed 10 to 15 days after emergence, leaving one plant per hill. Gap filling. The thinned out seedling is gap filled on 15 to 20 days after sowing, maintaining a spacing of 15 cm between two plants. Growth stages. Germination, 0 to 7 days. Knee height stage, 35 to 45 days. Panicle initiation stage, milking and seed formation stage, 46 to 90 days. Maturity, 91 to 125 days. Nutrient requirement. Transplanted crop. Apply NPK fertilizers as per soil test recommendations. If soil test recommendations are not available, adopt a blanket recommendation of 90 kg nitrogen, 45 kg P2O5, 45 kg K2O per hectare. Apply nitrogen at the rate 50:25:25% at 0, 15 and 30 days after sowing. And full dose of P2O5 and K2O basally before planting. In the case of ridge planted crop, open a furrow 5 cm deep on the side of the ridge at 2/3 the distance from the top of the ridge and place the fertilizer mixture along the furrow and cover with soil up to 2 cm. Direct sown crop. Apply NPK fertilizers as per soil test recommendations as far as possible. If soil test recommendations are not available, adopt a blanket recommendation of 90 kg nitrogen, 45 kg P2O5 and 45 kg K2O per hectare. Apply nitrogen at the rate 50:25:25% at 0, 15 and 30 days after sowing. And full dose of P2O5 and K2O basally before sowing. And if basal application is not possible, the same could be top dressed within 24 hours. Micronutrient. Mix 25 kg of zinc sulfate with sand to make a total quantity of 50 kg and apply on the furrows and on to the top 1/3 of the ridges. Basal application of 25 kg zinc sulfate per hectare for the deficient soils or 12.5 kg zinc sulfate per hectare plus farmyard manure for the zinc deficient soil. Basal application of iron sulfate 50 kg per hectare along with 12.5 tons per hectare farmyard manure for iron deficient soils. Water management. Total water requirement is 450 to 500 mm. Irrigation at 50% depletion of available soil moisture or 0.6 IW by CPE ratio is sufficient. For normal condition, 8 irrigations are to be given, that is on 1st day, 4th day, 15th, 28th, 40th, 53rd, 64th, 76th, and 88th days. Contingent plan. This should be done before 75% of soil moisture is lost from available water. Spraying 3% kaolin, 30 grams in 1 liter of water during periods of stress will mitigate the ill effects. Critical stages for irrigation in sorghum. Critical stages of irrigation are 30 to 45 days, seedling elongation stage, 60 to 65 days, reproductive or heading stages, 70 to 75 days, panicle emergence, 90 to 95, grain development stage. Weed management. Rain fed sorghum. Keep sorghum field free of weeds from 2nd week after germination till 5th week. If sufficient moisture is available, spray atrazine 0.25 kg per hectare as pre-emergence application. Within 3 days after the receipt of the soaking rainfall for soil sorghum and for sorghum-based intercropping, system with pulses use pendimethalin at 0.75 kg per hectare. Under rain-fed sorghum intercropped with cowpea as a pre-plant incorporation of isopro-turba at the rate 0.5 kg per hectare. Gave good control of weed with applied after first and second spec of rainfall. Pendimethalin 1 kg per hectare will be safer for both the crops. Weed management irrigated sorghum. Apply PE atrazine at the rate 0.25 kg per hectare on 3 to 5 days after sowing, followed by 2,4-D at the rate 1 kg per hectare on 20 to 25 days after sowing on the soil surface. Using backpack or knapsack or rocker sprayer fitted with a flat fan nozzle, using 500 liters of water per hectare, or if herbicides are not used, hand weeding twice on 10 to 15 days after sowing and 30 to 35 days after sowing. Apply PE atrazine at the 0.25 kg per hectare on 3 to 5 days, followed by 1 hand weeding on 30 to 35 days after sowing. In line sown crop, apply pre-emergence herbicide atrazine at the rate 0.25 kg per hectare on 3 to 5 days after sowing, followed by twin wheel hoe weeder weeding on 30 to 35 days after sowing. In transplanted crop, apply pre-emergence herbicide atrazine at the rate 0.25 kg per hectare on 3 to 5 days after sowing, followed by 2,4-D at the rate 1 kg per hectare on 25 to 25 days after transplanting. If pulse crop is to be raised as an intercrop in sorghum, do not use atrazine. Spray pre-emergence herbicide pendimethalin at the rate 0.75 kg per hectare on 3 to 5 days after sowing. Weeds in sorghum crop: Celosia argentina, Cyanodon dactylon, Cyperus rotundus, Dactylopterium aegyptium, Philanthus niruri, Euphorbia hitta. Sorghum affected by Striga. Unlike other weeds which compete for water and nutrients, Striga as a root parasite literally sucks the life out of sorghum plants. In doing so, growth is stunted and yields are greatly reduced. Striga infested sorghum field. Striga has been given the common name of witch weed because of attaching to the roots and robbing the host of water and nutrients. Control measures for Striga. Physical control. Hand pulling at too early stage may break the shoot and reduce the rapid growth. Sparse infestation should be hand pulled shortly before flowering to prevent buildup of seed. Such hand pulling should continue through to harvest and beyond so long as flowering is occurring. Cultural control. It has been noted that sorghum plant shading can restrict Striga growth when generous soil fertilizer is applied. In areas of high rainfall, factors such as high plant populations, recommended fertility levels and good weed control encourage lush crop growth and shading in spite of Striga parasitism. This is not feasible in moisture-stressed rain-fed areas. Crop rotation should be practiced with trap crops to stimulate Striga seeds to germinate without themselves being parasitized. Crops claimed to be effective include cotton, sunflower, groundnut, castor, dolichos bean and linseed. Unfortunately, once a severe infestation has developed, it may take many years to reduce tiger population in the field to non-damaging level. Chemical control. As tiger is a broadleaf plant, pre-plant herbicides such as atrazine, gold and flex show some effect, though non-efficient enough to be justified. Post-emergence use of 2,4-D is effective when sprayed on the tiger leaves. The low-yield cost sorghum is vulnerable to stalk twisting and lodging if 2,4-D is sprayed into the leaf pearl. Spraying should only be done trained labor and caution to the hazards. In summary, control of tiger infestation is difficult and requires an integrated approach. Non-host crops must be rotated, but 2 years in heavily infested fields with resistant sorghum varieties. Following good practices will help reducing tiger effect in sorghum crops. Plant population and fertility adjusted for soil moisture availability to maximize shading. Weeding and tiger control through hand pulling and perhaps limited 2,4-D spraying, and finally, care not to spread seeds of tiger through fodder, manure or contaminated soil on tillage tools. Cropping system. Commonly practiced cropping systems are crop rotation practices. Examples: two crops in two different seasons within a year, that is double cropping. Example: sorghum followed by chickpea. For a 2 year period, that is 2 year crop rotation. Example: year 1 sorghum, year 2 groundnut, year 3 will be sorghum again. 3 year period, that is 3 year crop rotation. Year 1 sorghum, year 2 groundnut, year 3 cotton, year 4 will be sorghum again. Intercropping systems. Example: sorghum plus cowpea, sorghum plus green gram. Mixed cropping systems. Example: sorghum plus green gram, wheat. Ratoon cropping. Example: sorghum plus pigeon pea. Insect management. Shoot fly. Spray any one of the following insecticides 10 and 17 days after sowing using 250 liters of water per hectare. Endosulfan 35 EC 500 ml per hectare. Methyl dimethon 25 EC 500 ml per hectare. Dimethoate 30 EC 500 ml per hectare. Stem borer. Apply any one of the insecticides on the foliage 30 days after sowing. Use 500 liters of spray fluid per hectare. Endosulfan 35 EC 750 ml per hectare. Carbaryl 50 WP 1 kg per hectare. Or apply any one of the following dust mixed with sand to make up a total quantity of 50 kg in the leaf pool. Carbaryl 10D 10 kg per hectare. Endosulfan 4D 10 kg per hectare. Avoid spraying and dusting in fodder sorghum 30 days after sowing. Yield attributes: A equals to number of plants per meter square, B equals to number of ear heads per plant, C equals to number of grains per ear head, D equals to test weight. Sorghum harvesting. Grain sorghum should be harvested as early as possible to minimize losses due to birds, insects, mold and bad weather. Mature grain sorghum in the field contains about 30% moisture. At moisture levels higher than 25%, the seeds are too soft to withstand the threshing action. The ideal moisture content for harvesting grain sorghum is about 20%. When the crop matures, the leaves turn yellow and present a dried up appearance. The grains are hard and firm. The crop is harvested by cutting the ear heads first and the stalks later. The stalks, straw, are cut after a week, allowed to dry and then stacked. Yield. Sorghum adapts to many environments, requiring 90 to 140 days to mature. Highest yields are usually obtained from varieties maturing in 100 to 120 days. Grain yield 2 to 3 tons per hectare. Store yield 8 to 10 tons per hectare. Storage. Preparation of silage. Silage is pickled green fodder, highly palatable and digestible. Dug out a pit in the soil. Size of the pit depends on number of animals, period of feeding and availability of fodder. Generally, 15 kg of silage can be stored in the pit, having the size of 1 cubic foot. Walls of the pit and bottom can be plastered with cement. Chopped green fodder should be filled layer-wise and each layer should be well trampled to expel air. Fill the silo 2 to 3 feet above the ground level, cover with plastic
Hay preparation. Hay is prepared after drying the green plants. Pre-flowering stage is ideal for making hay. At this stage, sorghum is soft, palatable and rich in protein, carotene and minerals. After harvest, plants are bundled weighing 5 to 10 kg. Bundles are kept in erect position in groups of 6 to 8 and sun-dried. After drying, the hay is stacked. Post-harvest technologies. Threshing. Drying. Cleaning. Grading. Packaging. Ratoon sorghum. Harvest the main crop leaving 15 cm stubbles. Remove the first formed two sprouts from the main crop and allow only the latter formed two sprouts to grow. Allow 2 tillers per hill. Water management. Irrigate immediately after cutting the main crop. Irrigation should not be delayed for more than 24 hours after cutting. Irrigate on 3rd or 4th day after cutting. Subsequently, irrigate once in 7 to 10 days. Stop irrigation on 70 to 80 days after ratooning.